Cooperation is very important between government to government, government and investors, and then investors and investors. So what I see here is a lot of cooperation between investors themselves and investors and government. So it is very useful.
We are looking forward to develop agriculture so that we can eradicate hunger completely. Now the experience we got from Israel during this visit here, we are real grateful to see to it that Israel has already eradicated hunger. Nobody can talk about hunger. So we also would like gradual maybe to reach this level.
I would like Israel to translate their skills in small scale agriculture to Sudan, because we are still small scale. I see them improving agriculture through irrigation, small scale irrigation and big scale irrigation. This is very important because irrigation is more efficient than rain-fed agriculture.
Now, one of the hot topics in Israel, if you mentioned Sudan, is of course the many Sudanese who are here in Israel who fled from Sudan. How do you see this issue?
What I would like to tell the public is that there is a difference between Sudan and South Sudan. In the past, we used to be one country, the Sudan, but now we are South Sudan. So when the Israeli people talk about the Sudan, they're talking of the total Sudan. But South Sudanese who are in Israel, they are not very many. And for humanitarian purposes, I feel the Israeli government should support all the Sudanese who are here, whether they are from the North Sudan or they are from the South Sudan, because they came here for a purpose. They came here because they were afraid for their lives. They came here to seek better opportunities. So I appeal for humanitarian purposes, they should be supported. They are not very many. Maybe they are
about... But should they stay here, or is the situation better now?
For South Sudan, the situation is getting better. But there is still a reason for us to ask Israeli government to support them still to stay here. Because at the moment, South Sudan is only 9 months old. 9 months old. So there are so many things that need to be put in places.
How does it feel to be part of a government that's really only a country, a state that's 9 months old?
I'm very proud that now, finally, we can call ourselves a country, first-class citizens. We have been slaves throughout our lives. And we are happy now that we fought to get rid of any slavery. So now we are a citizen. We come here as South Sudan, not as a second class or a third class of the Sudan. And we are very proud. It was a long walk to where we are. It is not yet finished.
Israel for many years was a friend of South Sudan during the liberation struggle. So this friendship should continue. They should come and also help us, particularly now that we've got problem with our neighbor, the Sudan. Our friend Israel should come out, maybe to lobby also on our behalf with the international community, because we want peace. We do not, we are tired of war. So that's why we actually want peace to continue, so that we live as neighbors, good neighbors.
Khartoum government is still not allowing South Sudan to go free. They are still fighting South Sudan. They are still bombing South Sudan. They want South Sudan to cowardize to their demands. First, they were stealing the oil. They took all the oil. Then we shut it down because it was useless to us. Secondly, they want us to pay price, which is not internationally paid by anybody, for the crude oil to pass through Khartoum. Thirdly, they want us to pay for their gaps. They have a lot of debts and they want South Sudan to pay for it. And yet, they know for all these years, they took all the resources of South Sudan. They did not develop South Sudan. They took all the resources and developed North Sudan. So it is opportunity for South Sudan to use its resources to develop its country.